Effective rope management is one of the most important parts of moving safely and efficiently through a canyon. I'm going to demonstrate the butterfly coil as a good technique for managing your rope while in the canyon. You start with either one or both ends of your rope, and I'll do this in both formats to demonstrate the different techniques. You start with about 1.5 to 2 arm widths of tail. You want to leave that for the end to wrap the coils together and also to leave straps to tie the rope onto your back if needed. From that point on, you simply take an arm width and lay that loop over your hand. Repeat the process, but this time you lay it in the alternating direction. Going back and forward, each time you lay that coil that you've created over the alternate side of your hand. When you get to the end, you'll be left with 2 sets of coils that are completely separate. You then grab the tails of your rope that you left from the start, wrapping them several times around the coils, nice and firmly, will hold it in place. You then take a loop, pass it through the top, over the top, and pull it tight. That will hold it all nice and secure. So that technique is the best one if you're abseiling on double ropes, if you just want to run both through ends through an anchor, toss the rope and go. If you're doing long abseils where you're joining two ropes, or if you're using single rope technique, it may be better to coil from a single end, and that will allow you to uncoil from one end and use part of the rope without uncoiling the whole lot. In that case, it's the same as before, but I've simply started with one end. I leave an adequate tail, and then I start the process, coiling to one side and the other, alternating back and forward. This will obviously take me twice as long because I'm only moving one strand of rope at each time rather than coiling the 2 strands that occur when doing it with double ropes. So this technique is also good. Okay, once I have a similar tail left to my initial one, I grab the 2 ends, the 2 tails, and again, I twist several times around the loops. I pass a small loop through the hole, over the neck, and then I pull that tight. The final technique, which is useful if your rope is quite long or if you're someone who has small arms, small hands, or just struggles with the weight of the rope. To do this technique, you can just create the butterfly coils over your shoulders. So again, I'll do it with the double strand. We'll start with the creation of our tails. And from there, we simply place the rope over our head, and we alternate side to side, forming the coils on either side of the neck. This is also easy because if you need a break, you can stop at any point and then continue on afterwards. The downsides to this technique are if your rope is wet, cold, and sandy, it can be quite unpleasant on the back of your neck. And taking it back off at the end can be difficult. So I recommend grabbing both collections of strands and lifting it over your head so that you maintain the midpoint. From there, we just do as before. We grab the tails, we twist it around the rope several times so that they're held nice and firm. We place a loop through the hole, over the neck, and pull it tight. And so you've got the same end result, which again can be worn on your back, but this time we haven't worried about having to hold the weight of the rope in one hand. So you can see that for some people that will be an improved technique. All of these end up with the same outcome, which is a rope that's neatly coiled and will avoid tangling and be easy to use at your next drop. When you're taking the rope apart, ready for use, you start by taking off that loop from the top and feeding it back through. You then remove the coils you added. While the coils in the main part will not introduce any twisting into the rope, those final swirls around the top will. So just place your finger between the two strands and run it along lengthwise to remove any twist in the rope. Now, when you're laying it down for use, you want to lay it down so that it's the side you started coiling is at the top, and that will allow the rope to come away freely without any tangles.